Okay guys, so once the rear wheel is removed, now it's the time to install another brand new wheel if the previous one was damaged, or it's a time to fix your inner tube. So if you are fixing your inner tube, this is video for you. But if you are replacing the entire rear wheel, don't even continue to watch this video. Watch my next video, how to install the complete rear wheel and how to adjust the chain. Now, to get into the inner tube, you will need to do some removal of the valve locking nut, which is a 12 millimeter right here. And inside of this valve stem, there is a core. I have a special tool for that core, which is has a specially designed tool for this core, and it has a, it's like a storage tool. So you need to remove this valve core, and it's inside of this valve stem. You don't have to buy exactly the same tool. It just happened to be that I was on eBay, and I've seen it that this nice heavy-duty US-made tool cost only $7 shipped, so I decided to buy it. Otherwise, you can use a plastic tool removal if you have one, if it's not broken. Mine is broken, that's why I don't like the plastic one. There is a metal ones up there in the same size, not as big as this. So anyway, remove this valve core. Unless your wheel is already, I mean the inner tube is already empty, you don't need to remove it right now, nothing. Okay, now to remove the rubber, many people using a big flat screwdriver or some kind of pry tool to pry it out. I don't really recommend any of those tools because they have a really sharp edges and you're going to damage your inner tube more than it is. So, I mean, if you're going to replace that inner tube with a new one, I guess you can damage it even more. It doesn't make any difference. But if you're removing your inner tube to patch it because you had a hole from the nail, then you want to be really careful because you're going to fix just one hole. But if you're going to damage with those tools in a couple spots, it's too much to repair. So you better replace it with a new one. Now, I have this brand new tool that I just received recently from Amazon. It cost only $34. It's a Ken tool made in USA, part number 32117. This is really nice tool. It's made in US, as I said. It doesn't have any sharp edges. Everything is really nice and smooth. And this is a good investment, especially if you have some more, small equipment at home, or you have another dirt bike or lawnmower, anything like that. It will help you a lot in the future. So $34, it's a good investment. Now, all you need to do, you need to pry it out gently, because even with this nice and smooth tool, you can still damage your inner tube. So be careful, be gentle with them. Now, this is a brand new tire. I'm just showing this you as how to fix it, how to remove the inner tube. This is a tutorial video. There's nothing wrong with my tube. And if you're going to be doing this procedure on your end, and if you live in a colder climate, or if you live like in Canada, for example, and you'll be trying to do it on your free time, maybe during the winter time, this rubber will not be as soft as now. So I would really recommend you to go to the heated garage or inside of your house or anything like that, that so this rubber will be soft. Otherwise, it's going to be really hard for you to pry it out from this rim. Now, sometimes if you've been using that wheel for a while, might be really hard for you to remove it because this rubber would be really dry and it will be sitting against the rim pretty tight. I would recommend you to use a little bit of water, okay, around your wheel, and just a regular dish soap. So that's for the removal and for the installation. It's going to just slide out from that rim really smoothly. Okay, let's do. Okay. Now you don't have to buy this tool if you don't want to. And you don't have to do it everything yourself if you don't want to. You can just go to any tire places and they will do it for you. But you will be paying probably 20, 30 bucks for this procedure. But if you have more equipment at home, this tool will help you in the future. So now one side is removed, and now you can just reach it with your fingers, that inner tube. And there you go. So if you're replacing the rubber, simply slide it out from the rim. Yeah, sometimes it's not as easy as it looks like. You have to apply some force. But there you go. So if you're removing rubber and the inner tube all together. Now installing it back, basically the same way, same procedure. It doesn't matter which side, it doesn't have any direction on this tire. So I prefer to put the sprocket to the bottom of anything like a cardboard or this soft material, like a sponge, styrofoam, that if I'll be working from this side and then install an inner tube, there is a big chance that I'm going to damage my fingers against those teeth. So I'm doing it like this. And now you remember I was lubricating this with the water and a little bit of soap. Now do the same way to installing it. So one side is really easy, it's there. Now you have another side. Now deflate your inner tube or remove the core that you will not have any air. And you start with installing the valve and then installing your inner tube. So to hold this valve in place, just that you don't have to hold it with your fingers, just use this locking nut, the original one, and it's gonna hold it in place for you. Okay, now just slide it under the rubber. Okay. Okay, now it's sitting there. Now if you wanna do some little lubrication again, because that was a lubricated side that I used. Now use some soap and start with pushing it inside. Now sometimes I use my knee to hold it down to help me a little bit, and then use one. To install it, you don't even need the second spoon anymore. But so when you'll be installing a spoon between the rubber and the rim, just try not to touch the inner tube, not to jam it. Okay. There you go. So it's not that hard. Everything is sitting properly. I retied your lock nut. Okay. And install your valve core, which is threaded inside. and get some air. So those tires, they need to have between 12 and 15 psi's for the tire pressure inside of that inner tube for your kids. Well, this is it. In my next video, I'm gonna show you how to install that rear wheel back in place into your bike and how to adjust the chain. Thank you. Bye.